All right. We're here today with Greg Ayres. Hey, Greg.
Hey, Allison. What's up?
We're doing pretty good here. Here we've got your 10 questions. We're going to start off with the first one. What's awesome. Your favorite word?
I would say awesome.
Why is that?
I seem to use it all the time. It's a multi-level word. I can really think something's awesome, and I say, you know, awesome, or if something's kind of sketchy, I'm like, awesome. So it's got a dual meaning for me, I guess.
All righty. What's your least favorite word?
Wow. I guess bills. Bills.
I think a lot of our fans will agree with you on that one.
Mm-hmm. Hey, Greg, you have a bill due. Yeah, I think it's bills.
Okay, and if you could have dinner with one person, living or dead, who would it be and why?
Awesome. I've actually been asked this question once, and the first time I was asked, it was I would like to have pizza at Ray's Pizza in New York with Joey Ramone. I think that would be my ultimate dinner date with a dead legend. But since I've already had pizza with Joey Ramone now in that question, I think my second would be to sit down and have a chitty chat with Gilda Radner, the late great actress. Mm-hmm. She was a big inspiration to me as a kid. And now that they've just re-released all of the old episodes of Saturday Night Live, I've started to go back and watch them, and just really amazed at what she could do as an actress, and just really funny. She's just an amazing actress. So, yeah. So it would be maybe pizza at Ray's with Gilda Radner.
Very good.
Just get Joey out and move Gilda in. So.
There you go. Which of the roles you've played is the most like you?
You know, I really think that now I've always said it was Son Goku from Saiyuki, because aside from kind of just sounding like me, he's a real feisty character. He's got a tendency to get in trouble, and also his undying love and loyalty for the people closest to him. But now that I'm working on Beck, I have a lot in common with Koyuki too. So it's a toss up right now between the monkey and the rocker.
Both aspects of the personality in there. which of the roles that you've played is the least like you, would you say?
The least likely. It would have to be Hajime Moroto from Gantz. I play a bum-killing, or I should say, yeah, I guess he's a bum-killer. A bum-killing, just a horrible, evil, evil little kid of... I remember telling Matt when I was working on it, I was like, you know, in all the years of watching anime, I've never hated a character, like, you know, hated the person mm-hmm. nearly as bad as that kid. But, you know, the fact that he is so different from me made playing the role that much more fun. But, yeah, I would say that's, I don't kill bums or young girls or throw hot water in people's faces. So, yeah, it would be the psycho serial killer.
Very good. Okay. If you could choose a theme song, what would you choose?
Wow. It would probably be Crazy by Gnarls Barkley. I think that's a pretty good walk-in tune for me right now.
Recommend a movie, a TV show, some music, a book, something that you think our listeners should check out.
Wow. Okay. Movies... it's an oldie, but a classic. I'm shocked to find out that so many people have never seen the movie Amelie. And it is just a life-changing movie for me. It's a Jean-Pierre Jeunet movie. It came out about 4 or 5 years ago. And it's a foreign language film. You have to read the subtitles. But just a beautiful movie from start to finish. Probably, I can't think of any movie that ever... made me re-examine how I live my life and try to do it a little bit better after seeing that movie. So definitely Amelie for movies. TV shows, I would say, Lost is a big deal for everybody, so I won't cop out and use that. I would say the Sarah Silverman program on Comedy Central is my current favorite TV show. I just love her. She gets away with saying the most horrible things because she's hot and she knows it. And I haven't seen a sitcom in a long time that could do break that reality barrier and break into song. And it's a really fun show, and I really think she's hysterical. Music, oh, that's so tough. I'm a DJ, so every day I have, you know, 6 or 7 new favorite songs of the week. Let me see. Girl Talk is an amazing hip-hop act, and I'm not really into hip-hop, but they sample everything from, like, classic Motown to old rock and roll, and if you're a music history buff, it'll just blow your mind as you listen to it, because you'll be listening to, you know, this new composition, all of a sudden you'll hear, you know, a Martha and the Vandellas, you know, bass line in the back, and it's just crazy stuff. So that's probably the most exciting and interesting thing I've heard recently. And I have one of the sound engineers, I have our Daikon Brothers engineer to thank for that, because he's like, hey, you have to check this out. So that's kind of my current new, like, hey, what's this? But there's so much good music, I can't really pick just one.
Spoken like a true musician.
Yeah.
Okay, if you weren't an actor and weren't a DJ, what else would you do for a living? What would you like to try to do for a living?
Well, you know, my background, believe it or not, my degree is in marketing and advertising. And I've always thought it would be fun to do, to open a small niche advertising agency. But here lately, I've been talking with someone very close, and I also like the idea of opening a small hotel that's kind of like a bed and breakfast, but more the idea of being at the hotel is not to stay there, go somewhere else, but to actually hang out at the hotel with, like, interesting stuff to do and really cool, you know, IKEA-looking rooms and stuff like that. So either my own advertising agency or a small, cool, groovy hotel, one of the two.
Okay.
Cool. So what would be the favorite series that you've personally worked on?
It's so tough. I get so emotionally attached to almost every show I work on. It's tough. I've been wanting to work on Beck for so long, and now that we're in the throes of that, you know, right now, that's my favorite. As far as being married to a show, I think the two that I was the most emotionally engaged in were Chrono Crusade and Samurai 7. So it's really tough, but Daikon Brothers is a big deal because it's my brother's first, you know, big directing thing, and I, you know, I'm a big Watanabe fan, so I don't know, it's a tough one. I always get asked that, and I can never, ever just pick one. And then I think back, and I'm like, well, there's Sayuki, and then there's Super Gals, and then there's, you know, Mystical Ninja Goemon, and, you know, it's like, there's all these different shows, and we had so much fun working on them, that it's almost like an old friend that you miss after the show's over. So I don't know. I don't really have a good answer for that one.
Well, how about what's your favorite series that you haven't worked on?
Wow. That's really easy. And it's a Write Stuff title, too. I tell this. I've been saying this since I first started working. I don't know what it is about Boogie Pop Phantom, but it has just always been one of my favorite shows. And the cooler thing about it is it's a show that I can watch and then a year later open that brick. I didn't get the cool box set when it came out. I still have my giant clunky brick version. But, you know, years later I can pull that brick out and, you know, start watching it all over again. For a while, here's a secret. For a while when I was battling insomnia, the menu music for Boogie Pop Phantom is what I would listen to go to sleep at night. Because it's this really cool, you know, ethereal, spacey music. And I was just like, I'll just listen to this. And it happened on accident because I fell asleep watching it. That's not the title you think of watching to go to sleep. But right. I fell asleep watching it, and I woke up, and the TV had already gone into sleep mode. And that's all I could hear was that music. And I was like, wow, what is this? And then it struck me. I'm like, wow, I'm listening to the menu for the creepiest show on earth. But yeah, Boogie Pop is. I think it's to me, it's a classic, and I think it's gonna always be one of my favorite titles.
Okay. Who is your hero and why?
Wow, there's so many of them. I would have to say my heroes are actually the people around me. As much as I would like to say it's somebody like Joey Ramone or David Bowie or Andy Warhol or, you know, the people that I looked up to as a kid, the people that really impress me are the people whose real lives I know. My friend Joe, who, you know, to make a better life for himself, you know, just up and joined the Navy, or, you know, a friend of mine that just recently got hurt that, you know, in spite of it, insisted on competing in a foot race. They're just people all around me. People actually interest me more than anything. And knowing people and knowing what they go through on a daily basis is kind of what gets me through to the end of the day. So, you know, as much as I would like to say it's somebody big and, you know, fancy, it's probably, you know, a guy named Joe or a guy named Josh or, you know, my mom or somebody like that. But yeah, those are my real heroes, or the people in my life closest to me that I get to observe and watch what they do and how they deal with things.
Okay, Greg, rounding out and finally finishing everything out. What are you working on now, and why should we check it out?
Yum, that's an awesome question. I am still working on the music for Beck. And this is probably the best part about doing Beck is that, you know, even though the songs were sung in English in the original Japanese version, we still have to, because we've done all the ADR work for the characters and those voices, it only makes sense for us to go back and re-record those songs in English. So now that I'm done with the acting part of it, now I just get to go up to Funimation and act like a little rock star and put my headphones on. And Mike McFarlane, who's one of my best friends, is my musical director on the show. So
cool.
So Beck is definitely a super checker outer. And I can't tell you any more than this, but I will tell you that the collector's box is so ridiculously cool that I'm going to have to buy two of them, one for each side of my stereo. And if it doesn't win Best Package Design for next year, I'm going to go hurt somebody. Because it's the coolest box set I've ever seen. And then the other is Daikon Brothers. Definitely because, you know, aside from the fact that I'm really proud of the work my brother did on it, just an amazing job of taking a show that, at first glance in Japanese, you would think there's no way this will ever be dubbed. Doing an amazing job with the casting, not including myself, but just, you know, finding voices that you'd never expect to sing the types of songs that they sing. And the show is just such a fun departure from typical Shinichi Watanabe show. While it's goofy and wild and it's kind of Blues Brothers-ish, we just finished recording the last volume, and it has such a great ending. With a lot of shows like Gravion or shows that have, you know, a real predictable plot line, it's like, you know, good guys, villain, battle, over, theme song, you know. This is really not like that at the end. This story takes a totally different twist towards the end, and there's some real hardcore things that have to be resolved. And the neat thing is, it really does leave room for a next season if Watanabe chose to do that, but not in the typical way that you go, oh gosh, they're just doing that so they can do another season. It really does, the story really does resolve itself in a way that you could say, wow, well, they could just keep going with that, you know? So, those are my two big plugs. Also, you know, Air Gear's coming out, Speed Grapher's still being released, Negima's almost out, almost done. I just feel really lucky because I don't really work on a lot of bad shows. I always seem to be lucky to get to work on shows that I love, so buy everything. Buy it all. But my two favorites right now are definitely Beck and Daikon Brothers. And funny that they'd both be musicals. You know, I recorded an album last year with the Voices for Peace people, and, you know, people were like, I didn't know Greg Ayres could sing. And it's so funny because I've been telling people, I was like, yeah, well, you know, that's how I got my start in theater, is, you know, singing. And then boom, boom, right, you know, two back to back, I'm doing two musical anime. So I hope we see more musical anime. Yeah, I really hope we see more of it. It's a lot of fun.
All right. Thank you so much for taking time out to talk with us.
Oh, not at all. Thank you, guys.
Thank you, Greg.
Thank everyone for subscribing to this podcast. I'm a big podcast nerd. So
I have
many, many podcasts I have to delete and download and delete and download. So thank you guys for listening and keeping the anime industry booming and bigger and bigger and bigger.